Good morning, students. Now we are going to discuss here the next remaining part of the topic leader of 11 topic of extension 111. So in last lecture we have discussed about the different types of leader. Now the next part is about the methods of leader and role of leader. In exam you might ask, define leader, explain different types of leader. Define leader, explain different methods of identification of leader. Define leader, explain the role of leader. Okay. So first of all, methods of identification of leader. Now first method is a discussion method. How you are able to identify leader? Suppose you are working as an extension worker for a particular village. You are not living in that particular village. Your residence is from other side. And if you want to do the work in that village, how you are able to identify the leader of that area? So first one is the discussion method. Okay. The person with a sound knowledge and ability should recognize. If you are going to organize a discussion among the people, among a group, the person having much more knowledge, he will try to share his information in that particular groups. So those having much more knowledge, we can identify that particular person as a leader. It gives encouragement and assurance to express the leader. By this method, by this group discussion, it gave chance to express our opinion, thoughts among the members of the groups to that particular leader. This make leader more confident in accepting a role of leader. As he is able to speak in a group, by that way it helps to develop confidence among him and he is becoming ready or come forward to accept the responsibility to act as a leader for that particular group. Now second one is the workshop method. Now in this method, the villagers are given a particular task by extension worker. The responsibility of the programs and decision making rest on a particular small groups. The responsibility decision making is rest in hands of the villagers or in the hands of particular groups. Over a period of time, as time passes, the work is going to be carried out. Over a period of time, extension worker can spot out a leader who come forward and taking the responsibility. Those person come forward, take the responsibility. By that way, we are able to spot out the leader of that particular village. Same method we are going to be organized while selecting the Ravi villages, while selecting the village for the NSS programs. So these methods we are going to be follow for selecting that leader of that particular village. Then group observer. Extension worker watch community or group in action and then spot the potential leaders. Extension worker watch the group in action. If activities are going to be carried out in village, he is just going to observe the members, how they are going to be act, how they are going to be carried out the works, and by that way he is able to spot the potential leader. Potential leader, that means the person who come forward taking responsibility doing work, that we can refer as a potential leader. Then election method, that is the method which is going to be conducted by the government to spot out the leaders through election. Now extension worker can guide the people in electing the right people for right job. He can guide the people which leader we have to select, which leader, to which person we have to vote so that they are useful for us for the development of our village. By explaining the functioning of the leader in relation to particular problems and outlining the qualification of the leaders, he will explain the how that particular person is able to solve the problems, what is the qualification of that leader or good qualities of leader, whether that person is according to the good qualities of leader. So that guidance we can able to give, extension worker can able to give in this election method. Now seniority and past experience. The oldest person is supposed to have knowledge, experience and normally can add stability in a groups. The oldest person, experienced persons can be directly considered as leader of that areas, of that particular groups. And basically they have ability to give stability to that particular. Stability, for example, if there are conflict, that conflict situation are easily solved by that particular elder person. Now key informants. The community or the people may ask to indicate the opinion leader of that area. Now opinion leader, that we have discussed in a types of leader. Opinion leader is a person to whom the villagers are going to take the guidance. Okay. So the villagers are asked to note down or to point out the opinion leader of that area. Example is the progressive farmers. Same way, the person who is guiding the people, that persons are identified with the help of these particular persons. they have knowledge about the patterns of influence in a social system. That means they have knowledge, information about which pattern is useful to influence the people, which pattern is useful to change the attitude of the people, to change the ways of behaving in, among the people. This method is usually cost-saving and time-saving, because directly we are able to find out the leader of that particular area just by discussing with the people, with the key informants. Okay. Now, self-designating. This is the method by asking the series of questions to determine the degree to which perceive himself to be a leader. Asking a question to the person, by that way, if he is able to answer all the questions, by that way, he will assess himself whether he is able to become a leader of that group or not. Appointing self as a leader in that particular groups. But how? By asking some questions, whether he is able to do, whether he is able to take the decision, whether he is able to coordinate among the people. By that way, we are able to select that particular person of that area. Then, sociometric method. Now, this deals with the social relations among the groups and individuals. It depends upon the relations, which kind of relations is present among the groups, among the individuals. Through that relation, we are able to identify the leader of that area. Now, sociometry is a means of presenting simply and graphically the entire structure of relation. Through this sociometry, we are able to present graphically the relation which is exist among the members of the groups. This method consists of asking the farmers whom they ordinarily consult for the information advice for farming. Asking the people to whom they are continuously discussing or trying to get advice, trying to get decisions, trying to share the informations. Okay. After a few interviews, the extension worker is able to spot out the community worker of that particular area. So that is the sociometric method. Means asking the people, number of people to whom they prefer, and the person whose name is majorly indicated by the people to whom they are prefer for guidance, that person we can refer as a leader of that particular area. So that is the sociometric method. So that is the methods of identification of leader. Now the another part is the role of leader. Now this role of leader is going to be asked in the exam. Mostly it is going to be asked either types and role of leader. Out of that, definitely one question will be there. So role of leader, first one is the group spokesman. It is the responsibility of leader to speak about the groups. Speak about the group, that means represent the interest of the groups faithfully and accurately. He must be fully aware about the group's opinion. He must present the problems, need, interest of the people or the group member to the higher authority. That is the group spokesman. That is the responsibility leader to speak about the members, to speak about the villagers to the higher authority. Group spokesman. Group baddal tela bolta ala paaje. Tyachya adchani, ade adchani demand sangta ala paaje. Group harmonizer. It is able to point out the group when the conflict situation arise. That means he must able to handle the groups when the conflict situation arise. Conflict situation is jeva vaad vivad hota teva tela solve karta ala paaje. The common purpose is worthy of cooperation and difference be solved peacefully. That means he must develop cooperation among the members and he must able to solve the conflict peacefully. Shantapane tela solve karta ala paaje vaad vivad. He should solve the conflict situation peacefully. He must promote harmony in line with the basic purpose of the group. Harmony, that means he must try to develop the cooperation among the members, uniformity among the members, and all the members will focus on the targets, on a particular groups of that particular group's objects, instead of conflicting with each other, instead of doing quarrel with each other. एकमेकांशी भांडण्यापेक्षा जो मेजर टार्गेट आहे ग्रुपचा त्याच्यावर फोकस करणं गरजेचं आहे. ते अचीव करण्यासाठी लोकांना एकत्र आणणं, कोऑपरेटिव्ह कोऑपरेशन त्यांच्यामध्ये डेव्हलप करणं, हार्मोनी डेव्हलप करणं, दॅट इज द रोल ऑफ ग्रुप हार्मोनाइज. देन ग्रुप प्लॅनर, ही मस्ट हॅव न्यू आयडिया फॉर इनिशिएटिंग द ॲक्टिव्हिटीज. ही मस्ट हॅव न्यू कन्सेप्ट, न्यू आयडियाज फॉर कॅरिंग आउट द ॲक्टिव्हिटीज. टू मीट द एक्सपेक्टेशन, ही मस्ट एबल टू प्लॅन, विज्युअलाइज, इमॅजिनेशन टू सॅटिस्फाय द ग्रुप नीड्स. टू मीट द एक्सपेक्टेशन, टू अचीव द ऑब्जेक्ट, to satisfy the group needs, he must able to plan and visualize that imagination. He must able to plan how to do the activity and accordingly how we can able to carry out the activities. So that planning should be in the mind of the leader. He must able to plan the activity. Then group executive. Executive means implementation, karyanvit karne. President, he presides the groups when group conducting the business. Presides the groups when a group is going to conduct the business, for example, self-help group. In that case, he must act as a presides of that group. That means he must act as a supportive role for that particular group. He must responsible to see whether the business is carried out according with the democratic principle. Whether the business is going to be carried out properly, whether it is going to be carried out in a proper way, in a good condition, there is no any fraud, nothing is going to be carried out in that business. So that is the role of leader, to see how it is going to be operated. Then group educator, he must able to educate the people. Basically, education is a cooperative advantage, in which teacher are acting as a guide for the students. And they share the followers his knowledge and experience. So in this case, the leader must share his knowledge and experience with the followers, with the members. This sharing and sharing of knowledge experience is nothing but the teaching. He must able to share his knowledge with the members. He must able to share his experience with the members of the groups. Group leadership is totally or majorly depend upon the extent, upon the teaching, how he is able to teach, how he is able to teach to the members of the group. So on that basis, the group educator role is going to be performed. On that basis, the group leadership is based. He must able to teach to the people his knowledge and his experience. There's symbols of group ideals. All the groups have different norms, ideas, rules, regulation, methods. Sorry. Leader must has to adopt these norms and live by them. He must have to adopt that particular rules, regulation, methods and live with them. Maje, he must have to adopt that all the norms. Basically, members are expected that the leader must has to follow. First of all, these norms, these rules must be followed by leader, then we will follow it. That is the attitude or tendency of the followers, members of the groups. So in that case, leader must have to adopt that particular rules and live with that particular rules and create example in front of members that I am going to follow these rules. So all of you must have to follow it. Okay. Then group discussion chairman. It acts as a chairman when group meets for a discussion. When group members come together for a meeting, for a discussion, in that case, he must act as a chairman of that particular meeting, particular discussion. Group supervisor. He must have knowledge of activities going on in a groups. Whatever the things are going on, he must have information about that things. And basically, in that situation, the professional leader should work with the leader. Lay leader is the local leader. He must work with the lay leader, and his role is not to take over the role of lay leader but advise him. In that case, professional leader means Gram Sevak, agriculture assistant, must advise to the Gram Panchayat, sarpanch, members of Gram Panchayat, members, chairman of cooperative society. He must, the Gram Sevak, Talati, they must able to guide to the people and likewise he must supervise the activities of the groups. So these are the 8 role of the leader in a society. Okay. If you are going to adopt this role, you will able to become a good leader of a particular groups. Okay. So in exam, 3 kind of questions will be there regarding this topic. One is the method of identification, one is the types of leader, second is the method of identification of leader, and third one is the role of leader. Definitely there will be one question regarding this topic. So accordingly, you need to prepare for this topic. Okay. So that is all the parts related to the role sociology. Now first part of your course, role sociology, is going to finish, and from next lecture we are going to be focused on educational psychology. That is the another part of your course. Okay. Thank you.